15.6D, complex numbers, powers of I. In this video, we're going to talk about something called an imaginary number. We define that imaginary number as an italicized I. Before we fill in the blanks, we should note that I is also defined as the square root of negative 1. If you plug square root of negative 1 into anything here on the left, you'll be able to mathematically see how you get the result. Let's take I to the 0. Any number to a 0 power is 1. Any number to the first power is just that number. So in this case, we treat I as just a number I. I to the second is where it starts getting a little different. If we look at I squared, that would look like this. And so if we multiply the square root of negative 1 to itself, we do indeed get negative 1, which is what I to the second is. I to the third is negative I, and I to the fourth is 1 again. Notice that if you multiply I squared to itself, that would be equal to negative 1 times negative 1, which is indeed positive 1. Notice that I to the 0 and I to the 4th, their resultants match. So we can use a trick to simplify extremely large exponents attached to the imaginary number I. Here's a trick. We divide the exponent by 4, because that's when we see a repeat in the pattern, and use the remainder. In example 1, we have I to the 223rd. So we take the exponent 223 and divide it by 4. 5 times 4 is 20. With the remainder of 2, bring down the 3. 5 times 4 is 20 again. And we have a remainder of 3. So we write I to the 3rd, and from the examples above, we know that I to the 3rd is equal to negative I, and that is your answer. I to the 96th is another example. We take the number 96, which is the exponent on the imaginary number, divide it by 4. 2 times 4 is 8. Remainder 1, bring down the 6. 4 times 4 is 16. Remainder 0. And so I write my simplification for the imaginary number as I to the 0, which we know from the example above is equal to 1.